This is really interesting. Take a look. Only three teams finished the season ranked in the top 10 for offensive rating and defensive rating. Celtics were number 2 in offense, number 3 in defense. Cavs, number 8 in offense, number 1 in defense. 76ers, number 4 in offensive rating, number 9 in defensive rating. Those are guys that you expect to be in the mix to win the Eastern Conference along with the Milwaukee Bucks. And strictly by the numbers, the Cavs deserve to be in that conversation.
Or Memphis. They missed by 0.2 points per 100 possessions on the offensive end because they were passed on the last game of the regular season. But they would have been the fourth team, top 10 in offense and defense, until they decided to go the other direction in the finale. But you're right. Like, that's the thing about the Cavs, right? And I think that's one of the things that's really hard to determine in terms of how far they can go in this postseason run, because there are a lot of markers that you would look at, Dave, that tell you that is a contending team. If you just did a blind resume and you looked at offensive rating, defensive rating, net rating, you looked at point differential, you looked at how many double-digit wins the team has, how many double-digit losses the team doesn't have, like all those things point to the Cavs being a legitimate contender. But there is a variable out here that I just don't know how to quantify, right? Like, beyond Donovan Mitchell, Danny Green, Robin Lopez, Raul Neto, not many of these guys know what's coming here in the postseason. Game one, Saturday night, at home against the Knicks. They haven't been there. Darius hasn't been there. Evan hasn't been there. Isaac Okoro hasn't been there. Dean Wade hasn't been there. Ricky Rubio has only played in two playoff series his entire career. And yes, he's got a bunch of international experience. And yes, he played for the Spanish national team. But if you go up and down the list, there just aren't a lot of guys where we can look at them and say, you know what? In a seven-game series, when it matters the most, the lights are the brightest, we know exactly how they're going to respond to that. We think we know about Darius, right? We think he's going to handle the moment. He's an all-star caliber player. He's been waiting for this his entire career. He's got the makeup, physically and mentally, to handle a playoff environment. But we just don't know. That's a variable that we just don't know. They haven't been through these things. They haven't seen these things. They haven't felt these things. And I think it might take a couple of games for these guys to really understand what it's going to take to play winning basketball in a playoff environment. Whereas if you look at the Knicks, and if you look at the Celtics and the Milwaukee Bucks and the Philadelphia 76ers, you don't have those same questions about the top-level players that the Cavs are relying on the most. Even Jared Allen has only played 9 playoff games in his entire career. Caris LeVert, 9 playoff games in his entire career. So the guys that the Cavs are expecting the most from, there is a level of uncertainty attached to them, unless we're talking about Donovan Mitchell, which is why Donovan is going to have to shoulder a lot of pressure in this first round playoff series against the Knicks.
Yeah, it's a fair concern, and it's the human element, which will make it even that much more fun to watch as it unfolds. Chris Fedor and I.
But if we just go, Dave, if we just go by what every team has accomplished in the regular season, there's nobody that should discount the Cavs as a contender, because all of their metrics that point to them and whether or not they do belong in that conversation, they would say, yes, they have been one of the best teams in the NBA during the regular season.
I agree with you wholeheartedly. It comes down to that whole human thing. How are you going to handle the spotlight? And you would think this team will be able to handle it. We'll find out. The lights are going to be bright. And think about this. It's against New York. You handle that, and then all of a sudden, the whole world will be talking, you know, about it. If the Cavs come out and play well against the Knicks, think about the national spotlight that will be shining on them.
Right. The other thing is, if they find a way against the Knicks, think about the confidence that builds. Right. Think about the knowledge that they gain in that particular series. And then they're better off to face off against a Milwaukee team with more knowledge, with more experience. And maybe they have a better chance in round two against a team like Milwaukee because of everything that they go through in the first round series against New York. Again, we're not going to get ahead of ourselves because the Knicks are a very formidable opponent. And Jalen Brunson has been there, done that on the biggest stage. And Julius Randle has had success on the biggest stage. And Tom Thibodeau has made life hell for some of the NBA's best players as a defensive-minded coach on the biggest stage. So this is going to be a battle for the Cavs, but they're going to be better off if they're going to upset a team like Milwaukee in round two. They're going to be better off because of the experience and the knowledge that they gain in round one.